Last year at this time, we were very disappointed and very surprised to see North Korea's nuclear development. And we were racing to the brink of the nuclear war. And we were very pessimistic at that time. But last night of last year's event, NARAC conference, I was really encouraged and pleased to see the next generation leaders of non-proliferation to be praised and to be encouraged by Dr. Im Man-sung's leadership and to raise the next generation leaders of non-proliferation. Whereas in North Korea, Kim Jong-un is praising and giving award to nuclear scientists and engineers by highest award to the proliferation world. So I thought at that time that this is a fighting and contest between proliferation world camp and non-proliferation camp. It is very important for us to keep 95% of the world opinion in support of non-proliferation, whereas in North Korea, they are praising and encouraging proliferation. So in that connection, I find a very meaningful work for the non-proliferation by NARAC. I define this NARAC as recreating non-proliferation support and expert. And we see North Korea developing nuclear weapons, and then NARAC is newly recreating. So it's a contest between proliferation and non-proliferation. And having said that, today we want to see the implications of the US and DPRK summit for the prospects of non-proliferation. Here we have a two-man game, and as Dr. Steve Miller mentioned, in conclusion, negotiated the non-proliferation efforts are more effective than coercive approach to non-proliferation. But we are very puzzled. Last year, Kim Jong-un was demonized and peace breaker and nuclear weapon maker. But this year, all of a sudden, he changed his face. And he becomes a peacemaker, and he has shown willingness to pursue denuclearization in very vague terms. So we want to know whether his intention is real and also in long term, permanent. And also we want to know whether President Trump is real and permanent in his pursuit of non-proliferation. Because as Dr. Miller mentioned, President Trump seems to be seeking short-term gains for his electoral victory by making some kind of a puzzle, the issue of North Korea nuclear issue, very puzzled. So we want to know whether this two-man game is real or permanent in the pursuit of non-proliferation. In this light, I want to invite Dr. Lee Sang-hyun and Dr. Seung-Yoon Lee and also Dr. Giovanni for their interpretation and also assessment of prospects for non-proliferation. I'll give each presenter 15 minutes for presentation, and we invited South Korea and United States and China. Unfortunately, we don't have North Korean. But in the floor, I hope someone play North Korea's role. Okay? Then I invite Dr. Lee Sang-yeon, who is a senior analyst in Sejong Institute and also current president of the Korea Nuclear Policy Society.